since that last bout. Walter can't hold some things in his mind for a long time. I said, "The spare room is yours any time you want. This will always be your home, Walter, and you'll always have me."
"Always be my home," he repeated.
"But I know he wants to live in Collingwood with his friends. He's a man of the world, after all." Then he settled down and we talked about Pat. We like to have a bit of a giggle about Pat. Pat Cruikshank lived opposite me for 60 years. But as I say, I've just found out she's been lying to me for most of those years. Her son, Kevin, takes me to see her in the home every Saturday. Mostly I go so I can play the piano for the old people. Like most people around here, Pat worked at the brickworks and drank at that pub. So no wonder she's got beer dementia. A cold snap last winter, followed by an unexpectedly high fatality rate from a new strain of influenza, on top of rampant gastroenteritis, meant there was room at the local nursing home. But it was actually getting her there that proved difficult. Kevin got her into my car by telling her we were all off to the races. Pat always loved a day at the races. We got her as far as the footpath before she suspected something. It was the suitcase. She attached herself to the lamppost and said, "Since when do we need a suitcase to go to the races?"